You hear that kind of that little raspy?
Yep.
That's good. That means you're. It's a very strong signal.
The strong signal that wildlife biologist Al Hicks hears is coming from a female moose. She lives somewhere near this wetland in the middle of Saratoga County and wears a battery-powered radio collar. In the mid-1800s, moose disappeared altogether in New York due to unregulated hunting. But since 1980, the moose has made a gradual return to the Empire State, and biologists are carefully monitoring their progress. Today, Al uses telemetry technology to track her down.
This particular moose, the hardest part of finding her is just getting the first signal. She's been very reliable about being able to see her once you get that signal. A lot of other moose, even though you have a radio signal, we've been in on them, and you never see them.
Al spots the collared moose some distance away through the trees. A bit later, we get a much better look at her out in the open. Al explains how we can tell the difference between a female moose, known as a cow, and a male moose, known as a bull.
Now watch her. Watch her when she turns. Look for her tail. And if right below her tail you see a white patch, about the size of your fist, all females, all cows have that. If that was a bull, if you looked at the base of the tail, all you'd see was black. You wouldn't see any white at all.
It doesn't matter if it's a cow or a bull. Al is just happy to see this moose, any moose, roaming the Adirondacks again.
And it's something of an honor to be involved in the return of a species that's been gone for over 100 years. It's great to see an example of the resiliency of nature. I had my son out here. He's only 4.5 years old. I had him out here a couple weeks ago looking for moose. It's something my father could never have done. So in that little way, the world's a little bit better because of that.